Fuck! Nicomo Koska stood in the entrance of the chamber, staring at the dragon and its bed. Sergeant Friendly walked towards it, sliding a heavy cleaver from inside his coat, took one crunching step onto the bed of gold and bones and papers, coins sliding in a little landslip behind his boot heel, and, reaching forward, tapped the dragon on the snout. His cleaver made a solid clank, as if he'd tapped an anvil.
"It is a machine," he said, frowning down. "Most sacred of the Maker's works," croaked Werdenur. "A thing of wonder, of power, of—"
"Doubtless," Koska smiled wide as he walked into the chamber, fanning himself with his hat. But it wasn't the dragon that held his eye. It was its bed. "How great a sum, do you think, Friendly?" The sergeant raised his brows and took a long breath through his nose.
"Very great. Shall I count it?"
"Perhaps later." Friendly looked faintly disappointed.
"Listen to me."
Werdenur tried to prop himself up, blood oozing from around the shaft in his shoulder, smearing the bright gold behind him.
"We are close to waking the dragon. So close. The work of centuries. This year, perhaps next, you cannot imagine its power. We could share it between us."
Koska grimaced. "Experience has taught me I'm no good at sharing."
"We will drive the outsiders from the mountains, and the world will be right again, as it was in the old time. And you, whatever you want, is yours."
Koska smiled up at the dragon, hands on hips. "It certainly is a remarkable curiosity. A magnificent relic, but against what is already boiling across the plains, the Legion of the Dumb, the merchants and farmers and makers of trifles and filers of papers, the infinite tide of greedy little people." He waved his hat towards the dragon. "Such things as this are worthless as a cow against a swarm of ants. There will be no place in the world to come for the magical, the mysterious, the strange. They will come to your sacred places and build tailors' shops and dry goods emporia and lawyers' offices. They will make of them bland copies of everywhere else." The old mercenary scratched thoughtfully at his rashy neck. "You can wish it were not so. I wish it were not so, but it is so. I tire of lost causes. The time of men like me is passing. The time of men like you—" he wiped a little blood from under his fingernails— "so long past, it might as well have never been." Werdenur tried to reach out, his hand dangling from the broken forearm, skin stretched around the splintered bones.
"You do not understand what I am offering you."
"But I do." And Koska set one boot upon a gilded helmet wedged into the hoard and smiled down upon the Maker's right hand. "You may be surprised to learn this, but I have been made many outlandish offers. Hidden fortunes, places of honor, lucrative trading rights along the Kadiri coast. An entire city once, would you believe? Though admittedly in poor condition. I have come to realize," and he peered discerningly up at the dragon's steaming snout, "a painful realization, because I enjoy a fantastic dream just as much as the next man." And he fished up a single golden coin and held it to the light. "That one mark is worth a great deal more than 1,000 promises." Werdenor slowly let his broken arm drop.
I tried to do what was best.
Of course. Koska gave him a reassuring nod and flicked the coin back onto the heap. Believe it or not, so do we all. Friendly. The sergeant leaned down and neatly split Werdenor's head with his cleaver. No! Shrieked Ro, and Shai could hardly hold on to her, she started thrashing so much. Koska looked mildly annoyed at the interruption. It might be best if you removed her. This really is no place for a child.